Hello everyone, so in this video again we'll be continuing off our discussion with the aptitude papers pertaining to the various recruitment drive, be it your off-campus recruitment drive or on-campus recruitment drives of various companies, be it your tech-based giant companies or your core sector companies. So many companies like the giant in the field of technological advancements like Google, Amazon's and Microsoft's and whatnot, they conduct their own recruitment process wherein they conduct an aptitude test. So these questions are not only those companies, but many service-based companies like TCS, Wipro, TechM and some on those orders, they also conduct the aptitude test as well. And apart from those, all the core companies do this well. Core companies, be it for mechanical, civil or electrical, anything as such. The question that we'll be discussing in these videos are basically one of those which have come up in the previous years as far as the aptitude section of this recruitment process are concerned. So we'll be doing this so that you can get a brief idea on how to, what kind of question you can expect in this kind of exams and how you should actually deal or tackle with this questions in general. So let's take a look at the first question of the video. There are two water tanks, tank A and tank B. Tank A is much smaller than B. While water fills at the rate of 1 liter per hour in tank A, it gets filled up like 10, 20, 40, 80, 60 ... in tank B. 1/8 of the tank is filled in 22 hours. So what is the time taken to fill the tank fully? Okay, so we are concerned with the time taken to fill up the tank B fully. Okay, so let time to fill the tank equal to x. Okay, so therefore in 22 hours x by 8 is filled because the water goes at the similar rate as well, so every time. Now let's take a look at the series that we are given here. 10, 20, 40, 80, 60. Okay, so this series is nothing but a GP series or a geometric progression series. Okay, where first term here is A and the common ratio, that is R, is equal to 2. You can see 2 times. So therefore, now if I am to find the 22nd term, okay, so if I am to find the 22nd term of the series, that will be, we'll use the formula T of n equal to A of r n minus 1. N is the term number of terms. So T22nd will simply be A being 10, r being 2, 2 to the power 22 minus 1, that is 22, 1, which can be that is 10 into 2 to the power 21. So this is equal to 1/8 of the tank, that is x by 8. Now if I am to find x, we can write this as 10 into 2 to the power 21 into 8. We can further write the same as 10 into 2 to the power 21, 8 we can write as 2 cube. So therefore we can write x as 2 to the power 24 into 10. Okay. Now if we compare this particular term with this term, we can see n minus 1 equal to 24. Okay, you can observe this part and this part, a here being 10 and r is already 2, so n minus 1 is 10. So in n minus 1 terms, our x, we actually have the total time to fill the tank, so x is satisfying the equation. So therefore n will be 25, so therefore total time required will be 25 hours to fill the tank. So I hope this is clear, the process that we have taken to solve the question in general. So this was a very typical IIT question pertaining to GP series. So with that said, let's move on to the next question. Yeah. So this question is a fairly interesting one. So let's take a look. 12 people, A1, A2 to A12, meet and shake hands in a circular fashion. In other words, there are total 36 handshakes. Okay. So each and everyone is shaking their hands. Involving pairs A1, A2, A2, A3, A11, A12, and A2, A1. Then size of the smallest set of people such that the rest have shaken hands with at least one person in the set is. So that is how we can come about solving this kind of question. So here, first thing we need to realize is that there are total 12 peoples, okay? 12 people. Now they are shaking hand in a circular fashion. So let me just draw a circle. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and 11, and 12. Let me just mark each and every one of them. Say this is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, 11, and A12. Okay. So now suppose A1 starts shaking hand. Okay. So A1 can go start shaking hand in this way. A1 will go start shaking hand, and finally the last person he shakes hands is A12. Okay. I hope this is clear. Last person he shakes hands with will be A12. So A1 will actually shake hand. A1 will actually shake hand with 11 other people. Similarly, A2 will shake hands with 11 other people. And similarly, A3 will shake hands with another 11 people. So if this goes, that is till A12 will again shake hands with 11 other people. So all these 12 people, they will shake hands with 11 other people. So we have 12 people into 11 handshakes each. Now one thing is to be kept in mind. Since we are sitting in a circle and we have assumed that the handshaking is taking place in a clockwise direction. But the handshaking can also take place in an anti-clockwise direction. That is, A1 can start off with A12 and they can actually go back and forth till the handshake reaches A2. So similarly for both the cases. So the number of cases, total number of handshakes in this particular cases will be reduced by half since there are two possible cases involved. So if we solve that, we have 6, that is 66 handshakes. I hope this is clear how we basically came to the conclusion. We have to consider to both the directions. Also, one more thing, for any cases to occur in a circular, there's also a set of formula like n into n minus 1 by 2, that formula. So this is just the explanation of how we arrived at this formula. I could have used this particular formula as well, but the explanation will give you a clear insight on the same. Since there are two ways or the two repetitions in general, so whenever there's a repetition, we divide the total number of outcomes by the factorial of that. So 2 factorial is again 2. So we have used that similar concept as well. Since there will be two similar repetitions, being clockwise and anti-clockwise in this case, so we'll again divide the total number of possibilities or the handshakes by the factorial of the repetition. That is 2 factorial, that is 2. So I hope this is clear. Where 66 is the answer. Now with that said, let's move to the third question. So third question is also a very interesting question. So let's take a look. How many four-digit numbers can be formed using the digit 1, 2, 3, and 4? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. So, but without repetitions. So one thing that we should keep in mind for any digit or any number to be divisible by 4, last two digit has to be multiple of 4. So if we consider the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so we need to form a 4 digit number, right? So how many numbers among this are a multiple of 4? We have 1, 2, 12 is a multiple of 4. We have 3, 2. This can with repetition, okay, repetition is also allowed. So we have 32, again multiple of 4. We have 2, 4, 24 multiple of 4. Similarly, we'll have 44 being a multiple of 4. We have 52, another multiple of 4. Apart from this, I don't think we have any other choices available. So with repetition, okay. So suppose I take the number, first number, say 1, 2, and we take 12 here. Again 1, 2, we have 24 here. 1, 2, we have 32 here. 1, 2, we have 12, 24, 32, say 44 here, and 1, 2, we have 52 here. Okay, so this, we have 5 digits. This place can be filled by 5 ways. Okay, this can be filled by 5 ways since there are no repetitions are allowed, and this place can also be filled by 5 ways. Similarly, this place can be filled by 5 ways. This particular place can also be filled by 5 ways. Similarly, 5, 5, 5, 5, and 5. Okay. So, in total, we have 25 into 5 ways. Okay. We have 25 into 5 ways, which would give us 125 ways. I hope this is clear how we arrived at the conclusion. So we can actually form 125 four digit number with the digit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which are divisible by 4. Okay, this could have also been done with a simple formula, that is the total number of digits, that is I, can be given as, since 5 to the power n minus I. Okay, so n is which number we want it to be divisible with. So here n will be 4. So 5, 4, and I will simply be n will be the number of digits. My bad. N will be the number of digits, and I will always be 1. Number of digit, and I will always be equal to 1. So therefore, again, 5 cube equal to 125. So this is a shortcut as far as the solutions are concerned. Okay, but this is the ideal method which we can use to solve this kind of problems. So with that said, we have come to the end of our video. We have discussed very interesting questions in this video. Hopefully all the concepts and pertaining to the same are clear to you. Kindly go through all the questions that we have discussed in this video so that you can get a better understanding on the same, and go through each and every question as many times as possible so that things are clear to you, and try to solve all these questions with this video as a reference, so for a better understanding. So with that said, we've come to the end of the video, and I'm signing out. Thank you so much.